Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Hope you all are doing good. I'm here on a trip to Thailand and today I'll take you around Krabi. Krabi lies on the southern Thailand's west coast and is famous for breathtaking beaches and picturesque landscapes. We had started our Thailand trip from Kolkata and reached Phuket a couple of days ago. I have made a complete video on Phuket and showed you around before we en routed to Krabi. If you haven't checked out my Phuket video, I'll link it in the description box so that you can go and check it out. We had hired a car from Phuket to come to Krabi. The distance between Phuket and Krabi by road is around 180 to 200 kilometers. You can also take a ferry from Phuket to reach Krabi. We had booked Ibis Aonang Krabi for ourselves and upon reaching, we quickly completed the check-in formalities and then relaxed in the pool. We did not have much plans for the afternoon, so we relaxed and then had an authentic Thai lunch. In the evening, we visited the Krabi Night Market. Krabi Night Market is held every Friday and over the weekends from 5 p.m. to 10 p.m. You must visit this local market if you are at Krabi. We were aware of this market and hence we planned our stay in Krabi in such a way that we get a weekend and a day to visit this market. From garments to food, fancy fabric bags to pearl jewelries, from painting to a variety of mementos, you get it all in the night market. Hundreds of shops with a variety of things to cater to the needs of every customer and visitor in the night market. And you get everything at a very reasonable rate. And if you can bargain with a smile, you get the best deals. We shopped our hearts out, buying mementos for ourselves and our families. And we also grabbed some food and mini ice creams while we were shopping. The shops cover a large area and it is usually very crowded. Along with food and shopping, you also get to see some cultural programs and performances in the street. You can choose to grab some food on the go or sit and enjoy some meal with your family. This market truly has something or the other to offer to every customer and visitor. The locals also visit this market and hence you know that the price you are paying for everything is authentic and not exorbitant for tourists. This market also has freshly caught sea fish, squids, prawns, crabs, so you can choose the fresh ones and get it grilled or barbecued for you. With our hands and bags full and yet pockets not empty, it was time to return to our hotel after an enjoyable evening at the night market. Just outside the hustle and bustle of the night market was the quiet town of Aonang. Just outside our hotel Ibis at Aonang, there was an ice cream roll stall and we could not resist ourselves to grab ice cream rolls. And hence, just before we went back to our hotel, we grabbed ice cream rolls. You get a variety of options in the ice cream rolls. You can choose from fresh fruits, chocolates, strawberries, dry fruit and nut, and a lot of other varieties. Durian flavor ice cream rolls are also very famous in Thailand. Durian is a similar fruit like jackfruit. It basically belongs to the same family of jackfruits. It has a very strong and pungent flavor like jackfruit. So people who like it, they love it. And people who don't like, they completely avoid it. Durian is also used in a variety of chocolates in Thailand. Fried ice cream was also available in this stall. It was quite amazing to see ice creams being made from scratch right in front of your eyes. These ice cream rolls are also available in India now. But in India, we often don't get the time and opportunity to make a complete video of this process. These ice cream rolls were quite cheap and it costed us only 40 Thai baht. We returned to our hotel, digging into the awesome ice cream rolls. The next morning, we had plans to visit the Four Islands. The Four Island tour is famous in Krabi and it covers Phranang Cave Beach at Raleigh Bay, Toop Island, Chicken Island and Poda Island. This was a whole day tour and we left at around 9 a.m. in the morning post breakfast. Lunch was included in the tour. When you are at Krabi and you plan to book Four Island trip, make sure that the lunch is included in your trip and also inquire if the transfer to and from your hotel is also included or not. For the Four Island tour, you can either opt for a long tail boat or speed boat. We had taken speed boat. The speed boat journey has started and our first stop for the day would be near Chicken Island, where we would go for snorkeling. From the dark blue and green waters, we were moving towards turquoise colored water where it is ideal for snorkeling. The sea was calm and hence the speedboat ride was not bumpy. We are almost near Chicken Island and we are getting ready for snorkeling near the Chicken Island. The island is named Chicken Island because of its shape like a chicken head, as you can see right here. The speedboat has anchored for snorkeling and we enjoyed snorkeling for around 30 minutes to 45 minutes. You do not need to pay anything extra for snorkeling. And the gadgets and equipments will be provided by the boat in case you are not carrying them. Also, 2 to 3 speedboats come together and anchor, making a boundary so that you can swim in and around and do not flow away in the current. In case you are new to snorkeling, don't worry because an expert will be there to assist you. Just a word of caution, though the water seems to be shallow, it is not shallow, it is just clear. So be careful. Know your expertise and capabilities before you swim away. Also, though the sea was calm and there was no waves, but the underlying current was quite strong and you would get drifted in the direction of the current, taking you away from the boat. The next stop on the list was the Poda Island. Poda Island lies 8 kilometers away from Aonang in Krabi provinces. This island is very beautiful and a picture perfect one where you can relax and soak in the sand, sun and sea. This island is also home to a number of Bollywood shootings and I'm sure you have seen this picturesque view in Bollywood movies. We enjoyed at the Poda Islands for quite some time before moving to our next destination, Toop Islands. All these islands are much less crowded than Phi Island and hence you can enjoy serenity without much people around you. Here also you could go for snorkeling or swimming within the marked safe zone. After enjoying Poda Island to the fullest, we en routed towards Toop Island where lunch would be served to us. We have reached Toop Island and this island is very beautiful. Immediately after reaching Toop Island, we were served lunch in a restaurant which was pre-booked with our tour package. Now it is time for us to relax and enjoy the island to the fullest. You can see how beautiful it is. If you are visiting Toop Island in low tide, then you can get an extra dose of adventure. The speedboat has dropped us at one end of the Toop Island and we had to wade through knee-deep water and move to the other part of the island, as you can see right here.
Okay, so we are here at Toop Island. So that's one of the islands in the four island trip that usually people go to Krabi. And here we are at the west coast of the island, so we have to reach the east coast and our speedboat will pick us from there. So now we'll show you the view of that island, and there is a sea walk between east coast and west coast, and we have to actually cross that sand made bridge kind of area. Through the sea walk we'll reach the east coast. So let's start the walk.
We have started walking through the natural sea walk, and trust me, it was an experience of a lifetime. It was so beautiful and serene, and the walk was really good. It is recommended to visit Toop Island during the low tide so that you can get this experience. However, during high tide, this entire area would be covered with water and it is not recommended to walk.
Again, we are at almost at midway. So far, we are safe. And water is knee deep actually, not too much deep. And we have to cross the halfway as soon as possible because our speedboat will depart in another half an hour. So let's start walking once again. Okay, so this is the place from which town where we started. Okay, so there is a restaurant. So we had our lunch there and then we started our walk. And so far we have come to this point. Almost 75% we have covered. And now we are again going to resume our walk. So can you turn your camera to the right? So that's the east coast of the island. This is our destination. So we'll continue our walk for hopefully 10 minutes and we'll reach there by then.
So let's walk. A safety boundary is also given at the two sides so that you don't go beyond that, because beyond that point the water is really deep. You can see the sudden changes in the color of the water and understand the depth by the color. Moreover, the areas beyond the boundary, you can have corals and rocks and you have a chance of hurting yourself also. Finally, we have reached the other side of the Toop Island from where our speedboat would pick us up in few minutes. The walk was worth the effort, and we really enjoyed walking through the sea. This is a long tailboat which you can opt instead of a speedboat, but the time taken would be much more than a speedboat. Our next destination and the last stop for the day in the four island tour was the Franang Cave Beach at Raleigh Bay. This beach is the southern strip of sand in Raleigh Bay. The Franang Cave is dedicated to an ancient god of fertility. Locals and fishermen come to this cave and send their offerings to the god of fertility. This is a caved beach and you can enjoy a swim in the caved part of the sea. This part of the sea lies in the shade of the cave and hence the water is cool, and you don't have to worry of getting sunburned in the scorching sun. The current at this part of the sea was very low and you can enjoy a swim like you are in a swimming pool, but this is a natural one. With the Franang Cave Beach, our four island tour had come to an end and it was time to go back to the mainland of Krabi. The four island tour is one of the most popular tours from Krabi. And when you are at Krabi, you must visit the four islands. Finally, with the awesome memories of the four islands, we went back to Krabi, and the next day it was time to go back to our homes from Krabi. Our Phuket and Krabi tour had come to an end and we en route to go back to Kolkata. I hope you enjoyed this video of Krabi night market and the four island tour. If you have, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed yet. I will soon come back with another tour video of some other destination soon. So until then, do take care and bye-bye.